The structure of my presentation is the following. First, I will outline the problem we are studying. Then I will tell about the objects and the study and the method of investigation. And then I will discuss the main results which we obtained by studying the electron nuclear spin dynamics. In the modern world, more often we should solve the complex problem. For this, it needs to improve the methods of investigation and developing of technologies. One of such ideas becomes the creation of quantum computer. One of the main elements for creation of a quantum computer is considered the solid-state quantum dots. And the logical qubits, as the logical qubits, using the orientation of the electron or nuclear spins in the quantum dots. The main problem for the quantum information processing is to increase the coherence time. The quantum dots is a semiconductor in which the motion of the carriers is limited on in all three dimensions. And the size of the quantum dot should be nanometer to quantum effects become significant. In bulk materials and quantum wells, the spin lose their coherence due to the motion of the carriers. In quantum dots, this mechanism is suppressed, and the main mechanism of the electron spin decoherence becomes the interaction with the nucleus. That's why the investigation of the nuclear spin system and its interaction with the electron spins becomes a very important problem. Direct observation of the nuclear polarization by optical methods is impossible. But since the quantum dots represent a strongly coupled system of electron spin and nuclear spin lattice, it becomes possible to receive the information about the nuclear spin system by studying the electron polarization. We excite the sample with polarized light and oriented the electron spins due to the spin orbit interaction. The nuclear spins polarized due to the hyperfine interaction with the photo-induced oriented electron spins. The electron spins fill the nuclear polarization, and also the hyperfine interaction allow us to determine the state of the nuclear spin system due to detecting of polarization photoluminescence of electron. We study the Gitterer structure contains 20 layers of self-assembled indium gallium arsenide quantum dots placed between gallium arsenide barrier. Every dot contains one resident electron. Here you can see this structure was grown by molecular beam epitaxy by method of the structures grown by this method have a very high quality and absence of defects. And this was the main factor for choosing these structures for investigation of electron nuclear spin dynamics. Here you can see the stem image of the few layers of quantum dots and a high resolution stem image of the one quantum dot. The original structure was cut in several pieces and annealed at different temperature. We studied two samples annealed at temperature 900 degrees C and 980 degrees C. Annealing provides the interdiffusion between atom indium and gallium between a quantum dots and the barrier. It leads to the changing of energy structure and shifting the optical transition, so-called blue shift. And also the annealing increases the volume of the quantum dot. It leads to the decreasing of the electron density of the sample. The mismatch of the constant lattice constant between quantum dot and barrier leads to the structure becomes very strained. It leads to the quadrupole splitting due to the electric field gradient. Here you can see the calculation of the distribution of electric field gradient, and the annealing decreases this variation of strain. Also, from this calculation was taken the was calculated the biaxial strain for two samples under study. Here, this slide shows our experimental setup. The sample is placed to the cryostat cooled till 1.8 K with superconducting magnet. The magnetic field is applied to perpendicular to the optical axis and ground axis of the structure. Two pairs of the Helmgol coils were installed outside the cryostat to apply a small additional field perpendicular and longitudinal to the optical axis. Also, we have the opportunity to apply a small radio frequency field by coils installed on the sample holder. The photoluminescence was excited with continuous wave intensifier fire laser and detected with silicon avalanche photodiode. In our measurements, we use different modulation techniques. For amplitude modulation, we use acousto-optical modulator, and for the modulation of polarization, we use electro-optical modulator. Here is represented the polarization result photoluminescence spectra for the quantum dots under study. The polarization of the residence electron were monitored through the effect of negative circular polarization of the light. The photoluminescence was principally negatively polarized with a positive polarization of optical excitation. We investigate the dependence of degree of electron spin polarization in the transverse magnetic field, so-called Hanley effect. In the classical Hanley curve in a CV, continuous wave with continuous wave optical excitation represent a Lorentz shunt. In this case, the electron spin processed around only external magnetic field. But the shape of the Hanley curve dramatically changed when the electron spin system interacts with the nucleus. The polarized nuclear spins affects on the electron spin as effective nuclear field. And the Hanley curve represents a so-called double wave structure. The process of formation of the double wave structure was explained by Paget in 1977. At zero external magnetic field, the nuclear polarization is parallel to the electron spin and stabilized it. Point one corresponds to the maximum polarization of electron spin. At small external magnetic fields, the nuclear field is deviates from the Z direction and electron spin processed around the total effective field. And its polarization reduced. It's point two. The X component of the nuclear field directed against the external magnetic field and compensated. When the external field totally compensates the X component of the nuclear field, the electron spin polarization is partially increased. Point three. And at large magnetic fields, the Hanley curve represents the classical depolarization curve in transverse magnetic field. Many years, researchers have the opportunity to study only static behavior of the electron nuclear spin system. Now, the new object and techniques appear, and it becomes possible to investigate the dynamics of such process. The Hanley curve we investigate the Hanley curve with different optical protocols of excitation with amplitude modulation. We study the rise and decay dynamics of nuclear spin polarization. To examine the rise of nuclear spin polarization, we use the excitation with fixed helicity and measure the nucleus negative circular polarization as a function or as a function of time after pump pulse arrived. It is the dark time between pulses was so long that the nuclear polarization is totally destroyed. At the first moment, the Hanley curve is narrow and no double wave structure is observed. With time, elapsed, the Hanley curve becomes wider and the dips around the central peak disappear. To examine the relaxation of the nuclear spin polarization, we measure the luminescence in a short interval after the pump pulse arrived. This interval was 1 millisecond as a function of dark time. Here represented the Hanle curve measured at different after different dark times. With the increasing of dark time, the Hanle curve becomes narrow and double structure is smoothed. To understand our experimental data, we divided the total nuclear field into two components. First component is a longitudinal component to the optical excitation band Z, and the transverse component to the optical excitation X component. The transverse component plays the main role in the weak external magnetic fields. And the dynamics of this component can be understood from the time evolution of the dips around the central peak. On the sketch of evolution of nuclear spin, nuclear field components, it is seen that the X component of the transverse component, X component of the nuclear field, increased from zero to its maximum value in a small magnetic external magnetic fields. The information about the longitudinal component, which is stabilized by quadrupole splitted of transition, can play the main role in a strong external magnetic field. And the information about this component can be extracted by analyzing the wings of the Hanle curve. Analyze our experimental data, we plot the time dependencies of the polarization degree for the weak and strong fields. And after modeling, we can extract the rise and decay time for the transverse component of the nuclear field. They are almost similar, 6 and 5.5 milliseconds. For the longitudinal component, we have more experimental data, and it's become possible to plot the field dependence of the rise and decay time for this component. It is seen that they have the different field dependence, and we haven't the theoretical description for this effect, but it can be associated with the rise and decay times measured at different excitation condition. Another interesting task was to explain the effect which were observed by Paget at the same paper. He measured the Hanle curve with application a small longitudinal additional field. And it is seen that the sign and the magnitude of this additional field is have a significant influence on the shape of the central part of Hanle curve. We know that the main condition for the formation of nuclear polarization is that the total effective field acting on the nuclei should have the component which is parallel to the electron spin. In exactly transverse magnetic field, the role of this component play the Knight field. Is a field acting from the electron to the nucleus. To understand the role of Knight field in the formation of W structure, we obtain a lot of experimental data with application a smaller additional longitudinal magnetic field with different sign and magnitude. To understand our experimental data, we analyze it in the framework of conventional nuclear spin cooling model. The dynamics of electron spin is determined by the joint action of the external magnetic fields and nuclear field. And the dynamics of nuclear polarization depends from the Knight field. We use the well-known description for expression for the nuclear field. And we know that the polarization degree of electron is proportional to the square of the total effective field acting on the electron and the direction of observation divided to the total square of total magnetic field. The calculated curves presented on these figures, it is seen that more or less good agreement, we can see for the positive sign of additional field in our excitation condition, it's co-directed with this additional field is co-directed with the night field. At negative additional field, the night field is antiparallel to the external additional external magnetic fields. When they are equal, the Z component acting on the nuclei of total effective field is equal zero, and it means that the nuclear polarization is not formed. It should result in disappearing of double wave structure. It's a red curve. At more negative additional field, the X component of the nuclear field directed against the external magnetic field. And when they compensate each other, the electron spin polarization should recover to its initial value. The amplitude of the central peak and the additional maximum should be the same. This is blue curve. This numerical results in a strong contradiction with our experimental data. This contradiction have an importance and indicates that this conventional nuclear spin cooling model ignores some mechanism of electron spin depolarization in external non-zero external magnetic field. To extend this model, we supposed that the total nuclear field acting on the electron consists on the regular component of nuclear field and the fluctuation component, which appear due to the motion of the oriented a limited number of the nucleus. We calculate the curves in with these additions, and we see the good agreement between the experimental data and calculated curves for positive as well for the negative sign of additional field. From this model, modeling, we extract the very important parameters for the interaction of electron-nuclear spin system. The maximum value of the nuclear effective nuclear field, the field of nuclear spin fluctuation, and the value of night field. Other method of investigation nuclear dynamics is the optically induced and optically detected nuclear magnetic resonance. People wrote, made a lot of investigation different objects. Few of them, it's in the paper of Akimov and Safarov, they investigate the aluminum gallium arsenide crystals. So they measure the degree of polarization on radio frequency field. On the figure, it is seen that the strong changing of the polarization exists when the phase of the frequency of the radio frequency field is coincides with the nuclear spin splitting in fixed external magnetic fields. In the paper of Kalevich and co-author, they investigate the bulk gallium arsenide. They measure the Hanley curves at modulation of polarization of optical excitation. And when the modulation frequency of optical excitation coincides with the nuclear spin splitting, they see the dispersion-like peculiarities on the Hanley curve. In another paper of Kalevich and co-author, they measure the NMR signal with slow changing of radio frequency field, as well as with the modulation of polarization and amplitude modulation. In all three cases, it is seen the resonances, and it means that the modulation of optical excitation affects as a radio frequency field. In another paper of Gammon, they investigate the single quantum dots. They measure the luminescence with different excitation helicity, with different sign of excitation helicity, with application of radio frequency field and without field. In one sign of excitation helicity, the nuclear field is subtracted from the external field and the Zeeman splitting is reduced. In another sign, it's summarized and Zeeman splitting is amplified, and then they apply the radio frequency field to restore the Zeeman splitting to the initial value. The first observation of the optically detected nuclear magnetic resonance in the ensemble of the quantum dots with strong quadrupole splitting were observed in a paper of Lisinski and co-authors. They measure the Hanley curve in CV excitation with application different radio frequency field. It is seen that the Hanley curve appear very weak peculiarities which shifted to the stronger field with increasing the frequency of radio frequency field. The Hanley curve have more pronounced results can be observed with modulation of optical excitation. The first curve corresponds to the CV excitation. Its Hanley curve consists of a narrow central peak and broadening wings. When we apply amplitude modulation in addition to the modulation of polarization, the Hanley curve represents a Lorentz sign. It means that the Hanley curve determined only by dynamic of electron spins because the pulses were very short and with high duty and the nuclear spin polarization is totally destroyed. Even stronger modification we can see when we excite with a modulation of polarization. The Hanley curve appear two additional maxima. And this appearing of this maxima is the main topic of this part of the talk. The position of this additional maxima strongly depends from the frequency of modulation of polarization. They shifted to the higher fields with increasing their modulation frequency. And their amplitude drops to the zero, but simultaneously the central part of Hanley curve becomes wider and additional shadow appear on it. Appearance of this additional maxima we explain as the effect of resonant optical pumping. It means that when the frequency of modulation of polarization coincides with the precession one of the nuclei, the longitudinal component of the nuclear field disappears and stabilizes the electron spin. It results in partially restoring of the electron polarization. Even stronger modification on the Hanley curve is appear when the radio frequency field is applied synchronously with the modulation of polarization. This curve strongly depends from the phase of radio frequency field. When the radio frequency field applied in a phase with the modulation of polarization, the resonances have the amplification. Green curve is without radio frequency field, blue is in phase, and this purple when the radio frequency field is not in phase with the modulation of polarization. To understand our experimental data, we calculate the splitting, nuclear spin splitting in transverse external magnetic fields for each isotope consisting in our quantum dots, taking into account the quadrupole splitting. For this sample, it was 1% Black-Scholes strain. We analyze the Hanley curve with the Gaussians and indicate that the central part corresponds to the transition plus minus 1/2, and the white part corresponds to transition plus minus 3/2. We analyze in such way a lot of experimental data measured with different modulation frequencies. And here on the figures you can see the comparison of theory, its lines, and experimental data, it's a point. You can see the good agreement between theory and experiments, and it can indicate that the theory taken into account all the interaction in the system. I want to say that all our investigation give us a lot of important information about interaction of electron nuclear spin system. I want to note some points. We create the original approach which allow us to receive the decay and rise time of the nuclear polarization polarization in a quantum dot center study. Analysis of experimental data allows us to conclude that the nuclear spin fluctuation play important role in the formation of Hamley curve, and we experimentally observe the effect of resonant optical pumping in an ensemble of semiconductor quantum dots. I want to thank my co-author and people with whom I worked from the Department of Solid State Physics, from Spin Optics Laboratory, and show from the Technical University of Dortmund. Thank you for your attention. No question.
No. Thank you. I'd like to ask you, how many dots do you use in the single experiment? Single in a sample.
Oh.
Concentration
Sorry?
Of dots.
How?
No, okay, yes. The spot was 100 micrometer. How many dots we can eliminate? I can't answer. Sorry.
You have never.
But it was.
You have never counted.
No, because the 20 layers of quantum dots. It's a lot of density of quantum dots, and we see the polarization degree of, in 35%. It depends from the sample. It means we. Polarized a lot of electrons, resident electron in the dots. It means that.
But I think that you have a very high sensitivity to registration, and so it's interesting how many.
I think we. Okay, yes, it can be interesting, but the signal from these samples is quite high. Even when you close all diaphragms and all everything, you still have the luminescence. And I think we will have the same results with 10 layers of quantum dots. I think there are a lot of quantum dots, so that's why we have a high
but,
signal.
But my question is directed to the to find out the equivalence of each dose, because it depends on the preparation, certainly.
You mean to find another sample made another method?
Yeah.
But. I think the molecular beam epitaxy is the method with the most high quality for such samples. Mm-hmm. I think maybe it's not very cheap, but now it's not a problem. And I think in our university we have the opportunity to grow.
Thank you.
Please.
Вот таких вот экспериментов
только... Да, когда микрофон хотел.
Да.
Не-не, ближе к рту.
Да. Вот. Когда говорят о таких тонких экспериментах и связывают их с квантовыми компьютерами, сразу возникает вопрос, как вот такой эксперимент, который достаточно долго длится, позволяет потом перейти к быстрым квантовым компьютерам, потому что мы уже привыкли по обычных компьютерах, что уже у нас частоты не мегагерцовые уже, а да, там уже 10^9 степени используется же частота, да, уже в компьютерах. А тут вроде бы времена релаксации еще достаточно большие.
Да.
Да. Вот.
Okay. In да. English or in Russian?
Да.
In English or in Russian?
Russian.
Russian? Значит, да, как бы это вы меня подловили. Ну, мотивация квантового компьютера, вы же понимаете, мы занимаемся фундаментальной наукой. Поэтому нам просто интересны процессы, интересна физика, интересно, что происходит. Квантовый компьютер – это просто красивая заставка, потому что как бы это была некая мотивация. Затем шел слайд с целью работы. И цель работы – это вот изучение фундаментальных вещей, именно взаимодействие электронно-ядерной спинной системы. Вот это нам интересно.
This is
Yeah, he sent me for the proposal for the grants and so on, not more.
Please, any more questions?
Работа очень красивая.
Спасибо.
Очень полезная.
Thank you again.
Thanks a lot.